just slapping around with water and all that stuff. Let's get back into it. So that was a rough league. Like, you know, whenever you lose to Jund, it kind of feels bad because, like, it's often due with, like, sweet top decks because that's what Jund does. The loss to Lantern was, like, they had it, and then that loss to Blue-White was, again, really good second game where they got me by, like, real close. Not a very good first game. Got a mulligan this, right? 1, 2, 3. Yeah. This could be anything, but this hand's just not very good. If I had, like, a Tarmogoyf, I'd play it, or if I knew I was playing a... Like, if my opponent has a Celestial Colonnade, or... then it's pretty good. Yeah, I think I'm going to talk myself into it. Okay. All right. The terms of engagement have been set. So I'm going to assume we're playing bottles, which means we are going to need a very quick clock here. But it's not a quick clock. And this is another thing that Death Shadow, like, Death Shadow is going to lose to decks that keep a ley line and have a functional hand before sideboard. We just got to, like, cross our fingers, and it looks like they kept seven. Like, what are you gonna, like, there's not much we can do there. They kept a functional seven card hand. We didn't do Liliana. Yeah. I could brutality. I can't even brutality myself. Yeah, we're gonna go to the next game. Okay, so against Boggles, I board out all of my grindy elements. Cut these. Bring in the Battle Rages, the Decays, and the Stubborn Denials. Cut my Terminate. And cut Brutality. I can actually cut a land. I'm going to keep in... So I don't like Brutality in this matchup. I am going to keep in a Culligan's Command because it just allows us to be more explosive. Like, we can attack with our Death Shadow on 3, go shock ourselves for Stern Street Wraith. I think it's better than any of my other options here. Like, I'm not in love with any of these cards. I like to keep the Lightning Bolts and the Fatal Pushes for Core Firewalker and Dryad Arbor. So, God, we have played two of the cesspool of Magic, of Modern Magic, last two rounds. I hate playing against... So, I guess I don't hate playing against Lantern. I hate playing against Bobbles. Lantern's interesting for, like, the first couple matches. So this hand's pretty good if our opponent has a ley line. But if they don't have a ley line, then it's not great. We have a Death Shadow. Death Shadow's our best card in the matchup. I'm going to keep this. Okay, so they have a ley line. Go us. All right, I'm going to cycle this now because we... Okay, cast this. We hit a fetch land. We're still a little short of a shadow, which is unfortunate. We could go, like, if we draw a discard spell, we're just going to discard our spell ourselves, get rid of this, and then traverse or something. And it appears our opponent kept another playable 7 hand, which kind of sucks for the home team. We're going to play this one out because I have a Death Shadow and I can, like, interact a little better. Just go like this. I'm not going to waste my Traverse. Hopefully they get something that lets my Death Shadow get into play next turn. Maybe I should have mulled my first hand, but, like, it's so hard to mull your first hand, your hands in this deck, when you could just get, like, especially when they're playing, like, if you mulligan, if you keep a 7 with no discard spell, and they have a ley line, it's very good. If you mulligan to a very discard spell disruptive hand, then it's not good. We had 2 Stubborn Denials. We didn't need a land. But if we draw a fetch land here, I'm in good shape. Okay. Guilt. I can't even cast this on this to help me move towards Delirium, which kind of sucks. Alright, this has been very unfortunate for the home team. Hopefully they give me something to point this at. If they just play a Dryad Arbor here. And if they play a Dryad Arbor, they're going to cast it because they're so landlight. Hey. What are you doing? Okay, there's Rancor, the big mean Rancor. The Battle Rage, though, could steal us this game. My opponent is at 17. So we're going to be able to get the Shadow into play this turn. And it's bigger than any of these things. And as long as they don't go land Daybreak Coronet, I think I've got a good shot. I'd love a fetch land. Because then that can help me Stubborn Denial. It's not a fetch land. Okay. Don't path my Shadow. Actually, I should turn off all of you. Because I'm going to... No, I can't even Fatal Push my Shadow. Alright, we'll take that. So we draw a fetch land, we're good. Because he's going to crack us for 4. They block. We go to 8, 16, fetch land, Battle Rage. Dead. If we draw a fetch land, we actually can get Delirium also, which is kind of overkill. Alright, come on. Don't do this to me. Come on, there we go. Fetch, Watery Grave. Dead as a doorknob. Get out of my face. Go Vogel yourself. Who was not the hand you needed to fetch? Oh, that makes sense, Sus. Like, just the shuffle? Okay. Yeah, no, you're right. You're right. I should have shuffled that Liliana away. Good thinking. There. Yep. You're right. 100%. Because then the traverse is like a shuffle to fix my draws. You're right. No, I actually want to board out the forest. Fuck. I think we can do better than this. Hand doesn't have a Death Shadow or a Stubborn Denial. Opponent mulligans too. So my opponent mulligans, that means they didn't have a ley line. And this Tarmogoyf's actually huge. Now I have 4 lands. Gross. I have an Abrupt Decay. So I'm going to keep this. My opponent's going to attack me at some point. I have a ley line. My opponent's mulligan to 5 on the play, basically. Because, like, doesn't do anything. Don't play a dude. Come on. Have a heart. That's actually, I wouldn't mind to play a dude. Don't, like, play something that gives it a million power. Fetch land. All right. I'm going to do this now so that if I draw a Fatal Push, I can kill it. It's a Virgin Cat. Sweet. I can kill a Core Firewalker. If I drew a Fatal Push. Okay, so we're actually almost to these Death Shadows. But the Pyro deck I played last night had 16. Had 16 lands in it. And, like, small sample size, but I really didn't mind. Okay, Ethereal Armor means that I can play Death Shadow. I can play 2 Death Shadows instead. So we're kind of in good shape. Because of this decay also. That's a good draw, but I think the green is better than the blue at this point. And I also, like, after I decay something, I can... After I abrupt decay something, I can traverse from my blue source if I really need to. My best draw would just be a fetch land. Because fetch land lets me have Stubborn Denial. And then I can, like, deal with all this crap. Alright. watch it upon it. So one card. They draw a card. That's great sequencing. So we're going to take five. I actually think we're going to win. Especially if I draw a fetch land. Because we then have Abrupt Decay with Stubborn Denial up. Yeah, I played 16 in my last league, which you can find all those replays on YouTube at Chopa. And it might be like, it was probably a little greedy, but I mean, I didn't flood out or get screwed really, which was pretty nice. All right, opponent shows some respect. So next turn, I'm pretty priced in to Abrupt Decaying something 100% to turn on my Traverse this turn cycle. And then just hide behind these Stubborn Denials is the game plan. That's all right. So this is not Vigilance, right? So I need them to do 7 damage to me. I need to not die, but like... Okay, so if I hit the Griff Spoon, right? If I Abrupt Decay this becomes 9 power, and it becomes 8 power. Because I need to take at least 7 damage. So let's go like this. Then we take this and then just attack and kill them. Yeah, go boggle yourself, you slippery bastard. Dryad Arbor isn't out. The last card's exactly Dryad Arbor. Okay. God, I would have been so peeved if their last card was exactly Dryad Arbor. Look at that. Look at that. You dumb Bogles guy. Go Bogle yourself. I wish I had Photoshop on my computer because I just see all these memes and all I want to do is just Photoshop my friends' faces on them. Like that's it. I just want to put their face on. Yeah, that was good. That one felt good because it's not often that I win a match when my opponent leylines me all 3 games. That feels good. What are you doing? What are you doing over there? What are you doing? You guys want a puppy cam this morning? I don't know if you can see him or not. Philly. Little Philly. It's my birthday on Saturday. I'm pretty amped for that. I think I'm going to stream. We're going to keep this because we're going to go Thoughts of the Talk Board. I think I'm going to stream the Modern Challenge. The Black Lab, Achopa. Okay, I'm going to stream the Modern Challenge. I think I'm going to put a donation goal called Bar Tab. I don't know what's a reasonable... I don't know, what's a reasonable amount to put on there so that people don't judge me. If I was to put a $100 bar tab, is that too much? Are people going to be like, wow? All right, so what do they do here? They put a card on top. So I just take the Mana Monkey because they have 2 Goryeos? Or do I... I guess I have a lot of outs to this Goryeo's Vengeance. My bet is they kept either a Fatty or a Faithless Luke on the top of their deck. So I have a lot of outs to Agorio's Vengeance, so I'm going to take one of them. Like, if I was to put a donation thing for my for a bar tab, are people going to judge me? Alright, if we could just, like, not do that again, that would be gas. I shouldn't have played my Forest, that was stupid. I just was, like, autopiloting, and I was like, Green Source, Tarmogoyf. I should have fetched. Okay, so there's one. We actually have some pretty good sideboard options. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 cards. Okay, so there's the Delta. So this is just like fetch Black Source, Mana Monkey, reanimate my Gristlebrand, and just absolutely kill you. That's what's going on right now. Sweet. Puppers. It's back to nap time. That's all a dog does. He wakes up, he eats, he poops, and then he sleeps. Like, what a tough life. I should plug my phone in. Give me one. Alright, so the fact that he's tanking, I think, doesn't mean that I'm dead. Alright, Island Simian Spirit Guide. Growth my Goyf, which is cool. Neony. So they got themselves a blocker, eh? Oh, that's gas. So now I'm just gonna escalate. With just two modes, I don't really want to. There's no need to gain and drain. -2, -2. And just ditch Traverse. Keep this land just in case we rip a Bloodbeard Elf. So my opponent can actually just discard their Goryeos if they want to blank this. Which looks like what they're doing. So hopefully they rip something that we can take here. So now we're wicked ahead because they not only they need Fatty, they need reanimation effect. So like, we are in shape. Delta? Which is better than Faithless Looting. Something that I was messing up while I was playing in my last league is that I would like go way too low. They went top. Okay. I would go way too low with Death Shadow. Or with not with Death Shadow, with my Faithless Looting. God, we're doing it. I'm gonna hold this just to give something else to discard to Liliana. Looting. Chart course. This card's so cool. Emrakul. Gross. Simian Spirit Guide. Alright, we're dead. We dead. God, we were so far ahead that we weren't. So like I was talking about, we want these. And this. I don't think this is like a Pentad Prism deck, so we can get rid of this Decay. We don't want Decay, we don't want Terminate, Bloodbraid Elf, Fatal Push. I'm bringing in Brutality, so Brutalities can deal with Jace if they need to. And then I'll keep in, and I'll cut a Forest. Yeah, this looks good. keeping the decays because they can just, they're just worst ones are worse. They're like shock. Oh no, I'm bringing the battle rage. I'm stupid. I didn't see those. Forgot about those. Forgot about battle rage. We have an out. We have an out, boy. I stopped playing that deck because of Stubborn Denial. Yep. This card just trades so efficiently. Because I would rather have these cards in my deck, and they're not very good Cascades of Chopa. I think it's basically kind of like a sub. Like, you usually don't have, these cards and the anti-combo package at the same time. Alright, this hand is decent. I'm going to be pretty aggressive. Like, I'm going to stub a cantrip on turn one. Then probably bolt myself on turn two and play Death Shadow. You got a ley line? Joke's on you. So snap stubbing your cantrip. Opponent goes with the no land. Oh, they're going to discard. All right, I see what's going on here. They're just going to discard and try to do it, and that seems like a rough way to do it. Bolt myself. Yeah, this is a tough way. This is a tough way to go about it. No, they did have the Delta. So they kept a no-lander with Leyline of Sanctity. That seems awful loosey-goosey. So Liliana of the Vale, not stellar in this matchup. They were on the play. No, they were on the draw, Swiftflame. They went bottom-bottom. So the question is, do we put the shields down and get Liliana in play? And I don't think that I exactly want to do that at this point in time. I'm going to bobble myself. Got another shadow coming, okay. So speed up the clock. So now I'm going to be a more conservative with my Stubborn Denial. I'll probably draw another one, then regret my decision. Just kidding. I think it's right to stub this because this is a it's a discard outlet and like fixing. My opponent's just dead next turn. So they have to go like mana source. They need mana source, fatty, Goryeo's Vengeance. They need mana source, fatty, discard outlet, Goryeo's Vengeance. The old Leyline of Sanctity. I'm just not going to play. I could just play this and not do anything with it, but like I don't really want to tick it up. Leyline of Sanctity also shuts off Niall's Spellbomb, which is pretty annoying for the home team. Simian Spirit Guide, Insolent Neonate. All right. There's a discard outlet. There's a Gristledad. Don't do it to me. I could have played around this. I could have played. That was stupid. No, they're just like, they were hoping I conceded, or they were hoping they hit off their draw step. Okay. Liliana was actually kind of garbage. So maybe I want just this K command to be more explosive. Like, I can shock myself, bring back Death Shadow, or bring back Street Wraith and deal, like, 4 damage out of nowhere. I think I'm going to do that. this card seems kind of like a little bit of a liability pending their draws, and it's pretty scary to not to play this without like a discard spell ahead. Yeah, I think I'm thinking that's a plan there. Dual shark. Yeah, I think we're gonna go like this. Like one blood raid. Yeah, that's defensible. Wow, this hand is an absolute heater. We draw a fetch land. This is a turn one Death Shadow. Wow, they don't even have a discard spell. This is gas. This is gas. All right, it just got even more disgusting. One. All right. We're fetching. Watery Grave, we don't care about our Tarmogoyfs this game. Okay, chat. Can I get turn two'd? What would they need? They would need mana source, discard outlet, fatty. They need two mana sources, discard outlet, fatty, reanimate. So they would need five out of seven would have to be perfect. They need two mana sources, discard spell, fatty to kill me. Guide looting, fatty, vendors. They need one more land, dual shark. Right? They need two lands. I feel like we're gonna turn three them as long as we don't get punked out. So let's not get punked out. Assuming Spirit Guide. Yep. So I take Chart of Course, or do I take Faithless Looting? Probably Faithless Looting because it's more mana efficient. I might have to go Brutality again next turn and not play the Shadow, which would like really frustrate me, make me very sad. A piece of one mana discard spell would be sweet. Right now, search for his Kanta. Okay, so now I'm just going for it. Like, they need two pieces of mana. We're not gonna I fucked up here, but that's okay. We're gonna get Stomping Ground. And I fucked up again. Because I could have just gotten a black source and bluffed this. Yeah, I messed this. I poorly sequenced all of this. Because I could have at least bluffed that I had this spell. So they ditched Seer Visions. So they would need... They can't do it because they need two mana sources. And Agorio's Vengeance. Yeah, I definitely screwed all this up. So this is gone. Don't do it. Oh, you son of a bitch. Insolent Neonate? That doesn't matter. All right. What are we worried about here? Like, I might as well just bolt this because it's not doing anything else. No, I don't even have to bolt myself because... This right here, I'm going to 10 off my fetch land, so it's 20 damage. I'm just going to bolt this, just to, in case there's any shenanigans going on. So they discarded a Gristlebrand. If there's anything that can go wrong here, I don't even really think so. Yeah. I wonder if I could have turned 2'd him. Get out of my face. Get out of my face. Get out of my face. Your stupid Comlodex can get out of my face. So I think I want to just talk about like the deck building a little bit here. Like, so we've seen those two games, and we've seen like how good our sideboard scheme has been against those two decks. Like, these Death Shadow decks just absolutely slaughter all these combo decks. So I think that's why I have the Bloodbraid Elves in the main decks, because if I have like 3 Stubborn Denials and 2 Teemer Battle Rages and I cut these two cards here, then all of a sudden my deck is like so much worse against fair decks that I don't really think that I can reasonably win two sideboarding games. So I would rather while there might be more degenerate combo decks in the format, I think I can beat them. I have a better shot of beating them with this configuration than I do beating fair decks with like this configuration. If that makes sense. This hand's like medium. I'm on the play though, so I'm gonna keep it. I get to go Bobble discard spell into Tarmogoyf. Yeah. I think Manamorphose is going to turn into the next Gitaxian Probe. Like one of those cards that we probably should have just been playing all along. All right, get this out of here. We're going to have a mega huge Tarmogoyf next turn. That's even greater. My Tarmogoyf's 1, 2, 3. And we can even play around. I was so stupid. I should have just taken another spell there. Yeah, I wasn't even like, I was like, I was not used to having these two things in my hand. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll just do that next turn. I mean, they're going to do this anyways. That was stupid to take that. I should, but then again, I'm not really taking anything. There's no other good cards, and at least if the Blood Moon's in the graveyard, it pumps my Tarmogoyf. Is Eldrazi Tron a bad matchup? Or just fine? Eldrazi Tron is a good matchup for these decks, because Tarmogoyf is huge. Regular Tron is not a good matchup. And I actually don't think there's a way you can make regular Tron a good matchup for this deck. Like, you just can't. Like, Fulminator Mage sucks against Tron from this deck. Like, people are gonna say like Fulminator Mage is the key. Like, you have Fulminator Mage on the draw and they Karn you, you just lose. You haven't even gotten a chance yet. The best way to fight Tron is with counterspells, and if I wanted to play land destruction, I would play like Ghost Quarter, because I can traverse for Ghost Quarter way easier. That's gas. So I'm going to attack first, because more than likely they're going to pitch their Emrakul. No, I'm actually not even going to play into this, because that just gives their remand a target. Because like I'm beating them to the punch. Yeah, you can Swift Flame, like, because the deck's just like super explosive. Tilt. So they've got the Steam Vents is gone. So now they're gonna bounce this Goyf. All right. So now we go upstairs. Get this Jace out of my face. Get this tapped. So 1, 2, 3. So if they have, I guess that the last two out of there, they're gonna get another draw step. So they need 3 out of 4 perfects in order to kill us. So we're just going like this. We're just gonna get 2 Tarmogoyfs into play. We're not gonna let them shuffle away their graveyard. And we're just gonna hope that they don't Emrakul us here. There we go. Okay. So this matchup gets pretty grindy after sideboard. So I actually don't know if I want my Bloodbraid Elves or if I want my Stubborn Denials. I think it's kind of an interesting question here. I think I can beat their deck without Stubborn Denials. So I think I'm going to start by playing grindy. And if they get more grindy, or if we see that they're sideboarding to go like pure combo, I think we're going to sideboard out those. I'm going to bring in my Spell Bombs because they play Snapcaster Mage. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you just can't kill Tarmogoyfs. Tarmogoyf is gas right now. There are less fatal pushes everywhere. Like, Tarmogoyf just doesn't die. I kind of want more Brutalities. I think we can ditch our K commands. I think our K commands are probably, we don't need to grind that much. Like, our opponent might just transition into a slower deck. And if we board in, like, our Stubborn Denials against their slow deck, we're going to struggle a lot. On the play, I could see bringing in the Stubborn Denials and just not, like, just suffocating our opponent. So I think that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to leave the third Bloodbraid Elf out because I don't think that we need that. I'm going to keep this Bolt in because it hits Jace and, like, some of their little shitters. I don't think so. I think Jace kind of took the Madcap spot there at Chopa. Which is what I think. I think that's what they should do. It frees up a lot of space. I'm going to go grab some Covfefe. I'll be back. This hand's good. We got a discard spell, a traverse, a bunch of selection. Like, we might not get to this elf, but we have turn one Delirium, which is gas. Basic Island. So is our opponent slippery enough to still be playing Blood Moon? So they went bottom. Okay. All right. So we're definitely fetching a non-basic on one because we can traverse for basics if we need to. Stomping ground. I think I want to draw that because I would like to turn these traverses into threats. I'm gonna have to restart Moto after this game. I'm gonna try not to show them blue because we might sideboard into blue in our next matchup. Blue to Delta on top. Spell snare, Remand. We're gonna take Remand. Because like now we can play around Remand. Like we find another way to damage ourselves, we can just go get Death Shadow. Which is exactly what we did, and we got another one. So we know our opponent's hand. Tarmogoyf, you are just never getting cast ever. Go get a Blood Crypt. Did I show them Watery Grave last game? Okay. All right, well now we'll make them think about it. Yeah, I did. I shocked at the end of the game to like bluff Stub. You right. Now we go get Double Shadow. Scalding Tarn. They drew that. Okay. This game's like super over, I think. There's another reason why this deck's just insane. Like, you just get underneath everything. We hit a land next turn, we actually get to just Bloodbraid Elf them. don't. They'd have to draw a lightning bolt. Where they draw a lightning bolt and I hit a land, I had a fetch land, they still die. Because the Blood Red Elf, in before Anger of the Gods, don't speak such hateful words, Punishing Waterfalls. I don't want to hear your negativity. Gas. Turn forward him. Didn't need it. That's why this deck is amazing. Like, yeah, we got a rough league. That's modern, but like, you can play this Jund game, and then you can just switch into the lean, stubborn denial game. Yeah, dude, I am so good at this game. I draw fetch lands right when I need them. I'm so good at this game that if I draw lands or spells, I can win. Let me see here. Dude, this deck is gas. This deck is absolute gas. Look at that. We've already cashed this league. We're 5-0 in this league. I would like to let the chat know that we are 5-0 in this league. Hater. Island. Blood Red Elf. Discard's good against Island. This card's pretty good against Island. This card's like whatever against Island. This card's decent. Gonna cycle before fetching. Alright, gasoline. School sucks. I'll take it easy, Dab to Graz. Oh, I forgot that I was supposed to restart Mudo. Oh, gross. We actually can get underneath this Supreme Brick. So let's take the Spreading Seas. We play two Death Shadows. Collective Brutality, the Supreme Verdict. What did they do with this? They went bottom top. So they probably kept a land. If I had to guess. And their hand might suck enough where they have to go like Supreme, because they might not want to play their click into a verdict. We knew about that one. We're just gonna play double shadow because the ceiling on double shadow is higher than the ceiling on. It's actually just more damage, but it's also like more potential damage. Now we just have to hope that our opponent didn't draw like interaction for these shadows. Something that is slightly annoying is that without a fetch land, my opponent can trade with one of these, which is like a tidbit annoying. I would like to draw just a fetch land. Field of Ruin, okay. So okay, they've got this all rolled out. Don't click me. I think I'm just going to traverse for a land because this red source is more than likely getting blown up. And then I'm going, and like they might click me here, but I really want to get the Supreme Verdict off the battlefield. Yeah, we're going to get swamped so that they take away my green source. And I'm going to attack. No, I really need to get this right though. No, I'm gonna attack first. Because I think they're gonna look to Field of Ruin. I don't think they're gonna flash this click in and block. And if they flash this click in and block one of these, then it makes their Supreme Verdict much worse. So I think it'd be a pretty poor play for an opponent to do that. But if I Collective Brutality first, they're going to flash a click in to block. So I think it's better to do it like this. if my opponent makes a poor play, which would be playing this Vendilion click to block, which it looks like what they're going to do, or they're going to try to field it here. Okay? I mean, I think that's a shit play, in my opinion, because, like, what are you doing with your Supreme Verdict, you know? They target me. Okay? And we put ourselves in the position for this to occur. But now the verdict's not even that bad, because we trade 2 for 2. Yeah, I think that was a crap play from my opponent. But it is what it is. Just leave that land in our hand. I would not be surprised if they try to field and ruin this red source on their main phase. And then we're not going to get a red source. And then we're going to cast 1 of 2 Blood Red Elves, make them Supreme Verdict, and Blood Red Elf again. Yeah, see, now what are you doing? Let's hope we hit a non-creature permanent with this Bloodbraid Elf. Go with this one. And I know I'm casting this into a verdict, but we have 5 ways to get this verdict off the battlefield. No, we're not going to cast that. So now we get him for 8. Next turn we elf again. And maybe good on my opponent. Maybe they... Yeah, and maybe, like, my opponents... Maybe they figured something out here. I don't know. But I think this click play was really poor from them. Because you make this a little worse. Now, they still get a 2-for-1 because I didn't really get a good hit off my elf. But I'm going to cast another Bloodbraid Elf. So, like... I don't know. What was our BB hit? I brought the K. Yeah, we hit a decay. Which, like, we're not going to get around that. We're going to get Field of Ruin. Or, wow, another Vendilion click. All right, well, I get to take away my Bloodbraid Elf. We drew a land, which kind of sucks. But again, it's like, what are you doing with this? I mean, unless you have a Jace. If my opponent has a Jace and they want to go Jace bounce this turn, okay. But I just don't understand, like, I just don't get it. Should have played my land. That was stupid. Odds are, like, I'm not cracking it, but it was still stupid to do. Okay, path. It's like, again, like, what is going on here for my opponent? They're just like, this Supreme Verdict is one of the better cards in this matchup, and they're just tossing it away. They go Snap Path. But then while they're tapped out, they didn't do that. Oh my god. Don't understand what's going on. I'm praying to the Yuga God. Right, Archmage, am I crazy to be critical of my opponent here? I'm gonna get just another red source. I really don't want to get whacked off this. They don't have a colonnade. So let's... So now they're telegraphing they have path to exile. So they just ditch their path. Okay, so they have Snapcaster. I'm gonna cycle this after we elf. Alright, there's another Bloodbraid elf. Though I could just have it be a Death Shadow. The problem with it being a Death Shadow is that my opponent just deals with it with a Snapcaster Mage Path to exile next turn. And then they clean up this. So I think I'm just gonna get more elves. I'm gonna attack and then I'm gonna cycle this actually. Can't always hard cast it, yes you can. And then after combat, I'm gonna cycle this because going to three is like I'm still one shot away from, I'm two hits from the Snapcaster. All right, and that's like, that's Colonnade Insurance. I'm all about. All about that colonnade. And maybe at this point my opponent's plan is like Snapcaster Supreme Verdict. One hit from the third click, yes. So now I gotta think about what I'm doing in my life. So if I Bloodbraid Elf and my opponent goes Snap Verdict, none of us are doing anything, and I've got his Colonnade covered. If I Bloodbraid Elf and have a shitty hit, then he just Path to Exiles me. Goes Snap Path, and then I'm dealing with two different creatures. I'm gonna be an adult. The problem is if I hit here, if I hit something really good, then I just die. If I hit something really good, they just go Snap Verdict. I'm kind of just stuck between a rock and a hard place, right?
Yeah, but dual shot. So I don't win by sitting on the Bloodbraid Elf.
He doesn't know I have this Fatal Push. So, like, maybe I just attack for three. My opponent flashes in Snapcaster Mage at the end of the turn to path this. They try to fire up this Colonnade and kill me. I push the Colonnade, and then next turn I Bloodbraid Elf. They have one card. And the last card is Snapcaster Mage. You definitely don't need to advance. Yeah, the last card is Snapcaster Mage. So, like, I think I'm just going to attack with this Bloodbraid Elf and then pass. Because if I get Snap Verdicted and I hit, like, Death Shadow, then I'm, like, up shit creek without a paddle. If I play this Bloodbraid Elf beforehand and don't really do anything, or if I just wait, they go Snap Path, and then maybe they fire up this Colonnade, I push this Colonnade, then I play my Bloodbraid Elf, and maybe we spin the wheel next turn. I think that's better. Like, I could be crazy, but I just don't want to walk into Snapcaster Verdict. And I could put like 40 power on the board here and then just get Snap Verdicted, then I'm up shit creek without a paddle. I need like one more good draw step to win this game. And I would not have won this game at all had my opponent, I think, sequenced their Supreme Verdicts right. And I'm gonna play a land out to just like, but the other shitty thing is they know I have this Bloodbraid Elf. I'm gonna do this. So now they go snap path. Thank you. I should have floated a green just to be a smart ass. Okay, so they're passing priority. Gonna F6 through this. Are they holding the path? What's going on here? Because now I can deal with this Snapcaster Mage off a Blood Red Elf Cascade. I think my opponent should just attack with Colonnade. Should hold this Snapcaster back.
Since you cast it, okay,
Yes, we'll cast this next turn. Beginning of combat. I'm actually going to let this attack. Because then he might attack with Snapcaster Mage also. You have to dispel me here. So now the Snapcaster Mage is no longer blocking, and we can hit. We can do it here. We can elf him. We got a couple outs to just win us the game on the spot. That is not one of them. So now I can't attack. I would doubt he would have Dispel in his main deck, and then if I push before attacks, he might not attack with Snapcaster Mage. If I let him attack, he'll probably attack with Snapcaster Mage. Since he cast it... No, I can't mean last turn, because he cast the Snapcaster Mage on my end step. Yeah, it's like... Dagger Graves, it's genuinely poor sequencing. What are they doing? Bottom top. All right, they got it. It's genuinely poor sequencing to do what I did there, but I wanted the Snapcaster Mage to attack. Okay. Want this? 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 These are maybes. And this is a maybe. Terminate can get out of my face. I like keeping in. Now, maybe I shouldn't have this Collective Brutality in my deck, because like, I don't know what I want to take out. Like, I could shave one of these just to shave it. But then I want all these cards. Like I would be looking. I think I want to shave a Brutality or an Inquisition. I kind of want two bolts, and I kind of want two pushes to deal with Colonnades.
J sticks are cracking, and people are playing stuff like Storm. Yes, the Shadow decks are very good. The stick is very, very good.
I think on the play I can cut one of these, and on the draw I'll cut a Brutality, because like I want to be able to have another crack to hit a Rest in Peace. I could hedge against that and cut one of these and then bring this back in, or bring this Inquisition back in. Yeah, because they're going to have Rest in Peace for sure. I honestly could cut a land because we're going to go long with them. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that too. This land's useless. I don't want to cut a red source. This land's just bona fide swamp in this matchup. So I think we're gonna go like this. Bring another Brutality in. Yeah, I think we're gonna do this. Game's gonna go long. We're gonna get to 4 mana. Alright, heater. So most times that you're boarding in stubs, trimming BBs, Yes. They just switch. It's like a fair versus unfair switch. I'm not going to fetch because I don't want to thin. It's marginal, but I ain't about the life. Hitting like a Spreading Seas. Gideon, ally of Zendikar. All right, well, we're hitting that Gideon. Well, I don't know, actually. We might be able to get on the battlefield. Like, if we just take this Blessed Alliance before we attack with our Tarmogoyf, we might be able to get on the battlefield enough where this Gideon is, like, manageable. Especially if we hit a third land drop and we can play Liliana. Because Liliana is going to squeeze him. And make it difficult to play this thing, and we can edict the token. They were bottom top, that's fair. Alright, so that changes things a little bit. So now I can actually Thought Seize the Blessed Alliance, play Death Shadow, then play Tarmogoyf next turn. Though that does all kind of go to... That does go to kind of hell in a handbasket if my opponent kept a Wrath on top. So I'm just going to play Tarmogoyf. We're just going to get on the battlefield here. My opponent easily could have kept, like, Wrath, land, something like that. Okay, plenty of you about that one. All right, let's check out what they're doing. My opponent Blessed Alliance is me. Then I'm just going to take the Gideon. If they don't, I'm going to take the Blessed Alliance. They might just target them with 4 life, which would be gas. Gain 4 life. Okay, that's it. Because now I can't play the Shadow. So now I gotta play this Tarmogoyf next turn. Because I can't. I gotta get around this Blessed Alliance. Though, I could. If I play Liliana, I'm gonna play Liliana, ditch this Death Shadow. And then if they play Gideon, I'm going to edict the token and attack. My greed is getting to me here. For sure. I don't think I'm going to attack with my Tarmogoyf. Well, now we're just going to go like this. Get this Death Shadow out of here. And if he... We're just going to pass. I think Gideon is a really well-positioned card right now because it matches up decently with Bloodbraid Elf. Like, the token trades with the elf and it has 4 loyalty, so if you can play it on a somewhat decent board, that sucks. So we are going to get to elf this turn. Then depending on what we hit, we'll figure out what we do against this Gideon. Makes a token. So if we hit a K command, if we hit a lightning bolt. Okay, so we're gonna cast this. Oh, that's not bad. So we go decay on this, attack this, and then do I tick up? Probably. If I tick up, it prevents... Because what is my opponent going to do next turn? Because, like, if they hit Wrath, they can just Wrath the board and kill this. But if they don't, then they can just Bless Alliance me. So I think I'm going to go up. This is kind of... This feels pretty mopey. Okay, so they still have the Blessed Alliance. So they can zero and kill this. And then we have to figure out how to deal with this Blessed Alliance here. Or plus one and kill this. The Blessed Alliance is going to be annoying AF. So maybe I should have rethought out how I played this. This Blessed Alliance just sucks. I did set Tarmogoyf for a Serum Visions too. So I need a discard spell. It's not a discard spell. Alright, so we're going to attack this Gideon. This gets Blessed Alliance. I probably shock myself with my Blood Crypt because I want to have my Death Shadows be larger than the Goyfs. Target player. Okay, so they're targeting me to be in life. Okay. No, they targeted themselves. Okay. So now I should have held that land. That was stupid. So we're basically going to scoop to a removal spell here. Because this Gideon just on an unopposed board is disgusting. I'm going to have to restart Moto after this match. Check my email. Yeah, that ain't good for the home team. So my opponent fives me. If we draw, and they have a colonnade too, so the colonnade's lethal. Okay, so I need Bloodbraid Elf, and then I need them to miss. Yeah, we didn't do that. God, I got cocky about the 5-0 talk. This is what happens. This is what happened. I do feel like both of those games were close. Both of those games were very close. And maybe I should have kept the Gideon. I should have taken the Gideon earlier. Their hand just lined up very well against me, I think. And I could have taken the Gideon. Maybe like that's just something that I should have done. Should have just been a better decision. Oh, gross. I think I'm going to keep this hand because we have three. This is like a very good curve. But this hand is definitely subpar. Oh, shoot. I forgot to restart Moto. Son of a bitch. Okay, so we're playing against humans. So I think I'm just going to take this Mantis Rider. I can take the Vial. Yeah, I'm going to take the Vial, and they just don't have plays going all the way up the board here. Then we can get this Tarmogoyf down. Going to try to... I think I'm going to protect my life total a little bit. There's the Ziggurat. Alright, that's actually a pretty good draw. It's going to put the squeeze on the Mom and Pop, which is important. So they play 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to get a forest. I board out the land when I board out the Bloodbraid Elves. So Mom and Pop's going to be kind of annoying. Okay, so I'm just going to play this Liliana. Edict this. Because I just want to... I don't want this Mantis Rider to copy this. And then next turn I can go, like, terminate the Mantis Rider Traverse for a Death Shadow. I don't want... Not the Mantis Rider, excuse me. I don't want the Phantasmal Image copying this in the late game. And I'm effectively trading Liliana for... Cavernous Souls, okay. I'm trading Liliana for Mantis Rider here. But it's going to allow me to like further my game plan a little better. Liliana is not that good in this matchup, so it is good that I at least traded here. And it makes my Goyf huge. Alright, I'm going to check out what they're drawing. So I know their last three cards. They're drawing a Reflector Mage. Vomit. That's disgusting. So I think I need to actually just, like... Do I need a Bloodbraid Elf? Like, how far behind are we? Because he's going to Reflector Mage my Phantasmal Image. He's going to Reflector Mage this, and I almost have to kill this Reflector Mage, or I'm going to keep getting, like, murked by this. Nah, I'm going to get Death Shadow. Phantasmal Image is going to be pretty annoying. But if they had Bloodbraid Elf, that would also suck. They could also play Mom and Pop this turn. Alright, question is, do I want to preserve my life total? I think I do. I can Shock here. I just want to get this off the battlefield. And if my now this makes it so that if my opponent plays Mom and Pop, it's not like absolutely god-awful. Because I can just start to beat through the tokens. My opponent can Phantasmal Image the Mom and Pop, which is going to be pretty annoying. But I wouldn't mind a discard spell here. Alright, well now we're going to go get Bloodbraid Elf. All of our hits are good here. That's not bad. Because that lets us take... Now, which one's worse for us? Probably the Phantasmal Image. Or the Reflector Mage. Because they're just going to Phantasmal Image my Tarmogoyf and my Death Shadow. Yeah, I think it's the Image. Okay, so if I attack with everything, they block here. What I need to be worried about is, because if I attack with everything, they can just block this and go to one. Oh, they actually can't make, red mana to do this as it stands, right? To cast to cast creature spells. So they can't throw these Thopters. So we're just coming in hot with the team here. It feels worse against Burn in game one, but I have four brutalities after sideboard. This is a Ziggurat, that's what they drew. And now we're just gonna continue to pile in on our opponent here. So they're going to Reflector Mage probably my Shadow. And they're in the Abyss. I can't beat Tron there, Scott. The blue-white matchup is still bad. So they have two cards and one's a Canopy. We still currently beat Mantis Rider. That was a shitty draw. But this has to block. Then next turn we play two Tarmogoyfs. And then they have to block all three. You can't use this to crack Canopy, that's kind of funny. Champion, okay. So they might hold this back now. They should make it so this... Okay, there's a freebooter. All right. We got two Goyfs, my friend. It's not good against Tron, and Death Shadow always struggled against Lantern. And I still don't think it's very good against Lantern. All right, that's a good draw. So let's attack first, because we're definitely attacking. They probably block here, because this is never getting through combat damage. Yeah, and then we're gonna Inquisition target Mantis Rider. Cavern Souls, okay. So we basically have to fade a Mantis Rider. I think that's the only thing that gets us. Thalia's Lieutenant doesn't get us. So while the Bloodbraid Elves were good there, I think that we have better options. Like, I think we can just sideboard these in and sideboard these in. Cut the Elves. I don't like K-Command against this deck on the draw. It's just too slow. And then cut a... No, I want to keep the Blood Crypt in. I could cut an Overgrown Tomb. Keep three red sources in the deck. I could trim on Street Wraiths. And keep maybe, like, these Bloodbraid Elves are, like, kind of okay. So maybe we can go something like this. I want all my cheap interaction. The Brutalities are kind of slow on the draw against Thalia, but then so is Liliana of the Veil. So maybe I want to go like this. And cut, like, a Brutality. Look to bring the Brutalities back in on the play. Like, this is kind of a Nombo, but, like, I need Battle Rage, and the rest of my cards kind of suck. Oh, good idea. Good idea, good idea, good idea. I just zoned out there. So the rest, like, the rest, a lot of my cards just blow, which is, like, kind of a problem. So, like, maybe I don't even want this Brutality, because this Brutality sucks on the draw so much against Thalia. My whole deck sucks on the draw against Thalia. So maybe I just want to, like, cut this, play this, and just, like, try to go over the top. But then we're down a mana source, but my opponent's not messing with my mana at all. So, like, 18 should be okay. I really don't know. This is why I think this human deck is very good. I don't really know how to sideboard against it, which makes me a little nervous. Like, I don't know if I should have Bloodbraid Elves, if I should just, like, cut these Bloodbraid Elves and bring in four collective Brutalities. Like, on the play, I'm probably going to try to get these in my deck and these in my deck, more than likely. And they're probably going to come at the expense of these. Like, these are bordered out on the draw. Now, I'm going to go with the commands are garbage and the brutalities are better than the commands on the draw. And then cut these four, bring these four in on the play. Break. And always, the problem is, like, it just blows against, like, pretty much any of the Thalias. All right, we have 17 lands left in the deck. Street Wraith's a redraw. Bobble is a redraw. So that's 17, that's 25. But Traverse isn't a good enough. So we have 25 out of 53. If this was a green land, I think I would be tempted to keep this. The thing it does is it does bolt a bird on one. My opponent mulliganed as well, so I think I'm going to mulligan. Yeah, this hand's much better. But, I mean, if the argument is the whole deck blows against Thalia on the draw, then we just shouldn't worry about it. We'll just be like, fuck it. Okay, we're going to naturally draw a land for Bloodbraid Elf. We don't need that one. So Lightning Bolt Tarmogoyf. If that doesn't do it, then... we were not meant to win this game. Gas. God. Combo. One red land and trip double red card. Huh. There's the odd there. 50%. So we're a little under halfway to do it. Okay. I don't think I just want to bolt them. I think we're just going to get a red source. We're not going to shock ourselves. We are going to shock ourselves. We're pretty worried about, like, Mantis Rider here. Reflector Mage would also be pretty terrible. What is that? Like, Han Solo, never tell me the odds? I'm gonna go get some more coffee.
Billy, we're gonna be walking through the office soon. Yeah, we are. You're gonna get a big walk-in today.
You're probably gonna be a pissant, too. Yeah, see, this is the nightmare. Okay, so we're gonna play this stomping ground tapped, and then pass. Probably lightning bolting this, unless my opponent, because if I lightning bolt this, it makes my Anger of the Gods, my Tomar Boy, survive through that. And I could just bolt the Mantis Rider and eat the Thalia. Okay, so I think now I'm gonna hit this with the trigger on. And then get a 2-for-1 out of Anger. My opponent. And then we can just follow, like, Anger, attack with Goyf, follow with Bloodred Elf. This card line is very weak to the card Mirran Crusader. All right, this is fine because we drew another answer to Mirran Crusader. So we get our twofer. Crack in. We get to bolt Mirran Crusader, Abrupt Decay something. We got a lot going on here. Untap, we Bloodbraid Elf. We get the BBE going on. Red. Is it Kessig Malcontent? No, it's Mom and Pop. Mom and Pop kind of sucks. That's a pretty good draw. As we could die. Like, if my opponent doesn't block, plays Mantis Rider, we die. So I don't really think I want to tap out for Bloodbraid Elf. Yeah, so like, this smells like a Mantis Rider. Or a Phantasmal Image, one of the two. Because like, he just plays Bloodbraid Elf and it doesn't do anything. Next turn, I can actually go like Lightning Bolt them if I need to here. Like, if they get aggressive, then I can just bolt my opponent. And they don't know about this bolt. We're getting aggressive. Okay. So now we're like dead in one to a Mantis Rider. We're dead in one to a Prime Mage. Hit this. So if we draw a land, they're dead. Unless they have an interaction here. And they might be dead even through the interaction. Because if we hit, like, a removal spell. Unless this is... this a Tarmogoyf? Meddling Mage, okay. So Meddling Mage doesn't matter if we hit a land. If we hit a land, our opponent's dead. And they have to chump block with this. Now, because they're at 7. Tilt. I'm gonna see what they're drawing. Drawing Fiend Hunter. Kind of annoying, but like, whatever. I don't think there's a draw they have that we lose to here with this Lightning Bolt. Because they have to block. We get to bolt this Fiend Hunter after the trigger resolves. And then we bolt the Fiend Hunter, or we bolt the Mantis Rider, and then untap. All right, that's a good draw too. And then we untap, play Bloodbraid Elf. been a little bit of a manhandling here. I don't know what this means, because you just die if you do this, unless you have like one drop. Because my opponent's like entire, like their last card has to be Mantis Rider for this to make sense. You take a point. Okay. You're still dead to a cascaded end removal spell. So we let this happen. Their last card must be like Mantis Rider. No, we're not going to do that one. Okay, so we're dead to Mantis Rider. Which is what their play would suggest, that Mantis Rider is their last card. With the two... Because I had a Lightning Bolt, Dual Shark. Alright, 4-1. With that league... Do I want to do another one, or do I want to hang out with the pupper? Regardless, let me go put my sponsor screen up here and then restart my mail. So. So what did we lost today? We lost to Blue-White Control twice. We lost to Jund once. We beat every stupid combo deck we played against. Moto's just loading up.